Good evening. So this is a quiz clash. We are going to discuss the another topic, the properties of matter. So far we discussed that properties of solid. One important property is called elasticity. We have seen elasticity thoroughly in previous classes. But in this class, we are going to see about fluid dynamics or fluid statics. Only we are having fluid statics. In this topic, we are going to see about introduction, Pascal's and Archimedes principle, relative density problems. What is actually this chapter is, what is the problem in this chapter means, in our syllabus, we are not having such a elaborate manner. We are not giving much importance for fluid statics. That is the thing. You are directly going for another topic. So that, but we have to concentrate, we have to understand in the fluid, very fundamental thing. The Pascal's Archimedes principle, relative density, everything. Relative density is very important topic. So fluid statistics. What are fluid? I already told you that the fluid can be flow from one place to another place are called fluid. The liquid and gases are called fluid. Solid is not fluid. Liquid and gases are called fluid. Fluid is a substance. Fluid is a substance that can flow and does not have a shape of its own. All liquids and gases. The previous class also I have given example. Fluid. Somebody making biryani. In 4 or 5 houses away, even though in our house, we can say something happening in that particular house. How? We are snuffing, snuffing. So actually it passes you. So it is called fluid and liquid. All water, all other liquids are also fluids. Fluid at rest. At rest cannot sustain a tangential force. That is a thing we have to understand. Fluid at rest cannot sustain a tangential force. The free surface of the liquid at rest under gravity in a container is horizontal, not tangential. What is the meaning of that? If you take any container, a beaker in which water is taken, very good known liquid is water. So among this water is taken like that, this surface is called free surface. This is attached to the wall of the container. All the three sides are attached to the walls of the container. What happened the top? This top is called free surface. That is the thing. Since it is inside the beaker, it is at rest. That is the meaning, at rest. The free surface of the liquid at rest under gravity in a container is horizontal. This is called free surface, horizontal surface. No tangential force, only horizontal. The force of gravity acts vertically downwards. This is a gravity. We know gravity is always acting downwards. The gravity force always acting downwards, vertically downwards. That is called horizontal. This is a horizontal force. The normal force per unit area. What is called pressure? Pressure is nothing but force acting on unit area. Or force divided by area will give pressure. In general formula for force, we have discussed in the elasticity also, pressure divided by area. Or pressure is equal to force divided by area. Pressure is equal to force divided by area. Therefore, what is pressure? Force acting on unit area. F by A is called pressure. So usually one question asked in the entrance. In all the NCERT examination, if you are having a pin, the sharp edged pin, if you are presses the sharp edged pin by your leg, you feel pain. But suppose there is a big stone or big rock will be there. You are standing on the rock. You are also having pain. So two example I have given. The first example, you are standing on the sharp pin. Second one, you are standing on big rock. There you are getting more pain. Immediately, you know, at the sharp pin only. Why? What is the reason for that? What is physics that? You cannot say it is a sharp like that. So that the definition is very important. The pressure is equal to force divided by area. Therefore, in the sharp pin, what happened? Area is small. If area is small, area is in the denominator, pressure is more. If pressure is more, pain is also more. In the big rock, the area of the surface is large. Since area is large, pressure is less, pain also less. Only because of this reducing the pressure, have you traveled in your bus, in a school bus, on regular bus, route bus? Have you seen the back wheel? The back wheel of the bus always containing how many wheels? Two wheels. When compared to front tire. So in the front tire we are having one tire. In the back of the bus we are having two wheels. Right hand side two wheels, left hand side two wheels. Why? Because if you are attaching the two wheel, the area of the wheel may be large. If area of the wheel is large means pressure is less. If the pressure is less means we are safely traveling in the bus. So that the wheel number may be increased because to travel safe. So you are purchasing a car. If you are purchasing a car for 4 lakhs or 5 lakhs, you can also able to purchase a car by 90 lakhs. 90 lakhs, you are simply, you cannot compare. So only 4 lakh or 5 lakh car is purchasing the car for 70 lakhs or 80 lakhs. We cannot compare because kindly go through the wheel size, the rim size 18, 19, 20. Therefore, if you are having the Audi car and the BMW, the imported cars, have you seen the tire? Very broad. So if it is a very broad tire, if you are go more speed, we can balance the vehicle. But unfortunately, we are purchasing a low cost vehicle and we want to go such a speed means accidents happening. Today also, I have seen the paper, some car toppled, simply toppled. That we are seeing the wheel upwards. The height of the car entirely reversed. What happened? Because of the tire is very, very important. So for a safe travel, we have to concentrate more on tire. But nobody bother about the tire. That is a problem in our area, in Asian countries. Therefore, what is my concept is, pressure is equal to force acting on unit area or force divided by area will give pressure. But suppose, I already give an example, a beaker in which a liquid is taken. The free surface is above, is called free surface. All the other three sides are attached to the walls of the container. But suppose P naught is the pressure at the free surface. So, just we have seen again. This is a beaker. This is a liquid inside a beaker. This surface is called free surface. If P naught is the pressure at the free surface, what is the pressure at the height or depth? Free surface of the liquid of density rho. The pressure at the depth H. So this is a height. This is a depth. The pressure becomes P is equal to P naught plus H rho G. So in the previous class itself, I have given the formula for pressure, H rho G, how it comes. Very, very important. You have to clear on that. How? Pressure. So, just now, we know pressure is equal to force divided by area. We know force is nothing but mass into gravity by area. We know mass, volume into density, volume into density, volume area into depth or height, this is called volume, into density rho into g divided by a. So this a getting cancelled. therefore we arrive at a formula for pressure, h rho g. So the pressure is an important formula, h rho g. If you know that depth or height and rho and g, substitute it, we can have the pressure. So that h rho g. So the pressure at a depth h, the formula is p naught plus h rho g. Keep your mind. What is p? Pressure at any depth. The pressure p is same at all point at the same depth. That is called Pascal's law. We will clear later. The pressure p is same at all points at the same depth, because depth h. If h differs, pressure also differs. For a particular height h, the pressure is same. It acts normally on any area. What is the direction of that pressure? May be act normally on any area. For gases, rho is very small. Rho means density. We know the density of gas is very small, so that it float easily. For gases, density is very small. Therefore, the variation in the pressure with the height is negligible. So, if a density of different gases may be have different pressure, we need not go like that, because the density of gases, all gases are very very small when compared to liquid and solid. Therefore, pressure with the height is negligible. If h is very large, not true, very big height, then the density plays an important role. But we not go such a depth. So as far as a normal height, we need not worry about the density. You should not keep like that. For all height, we need not changes with the density. But density for certain minimum height. If the height is very very large, you have to take consider the density also. Then Pascal's principle. So just now I told, pressure applied on any point of an enclosed fluid is transmitted undiminished to every part of the fluid. So this is a Pascal's law. Pressure applied on any part of an enclosed fluid is transmitted, it is not undiminished. Kindly make correction. Transmitted, it is not undiminished. Pressure applied on any part of an enclosed fluid is transmitted undiminished. Correct. Undiminished. UNDAMINISHED. Undiminished. That is a correct word. Undiminished to every part of the fluid. That means equal. Equal. It won't be reduced or increased to every part of the fluid. Very good example for Pascal's principle, hydraulic lift, LIFT. Hydraulic lift, LIFT. Hydraulic lift, hydraulic brake, BR. Hydraulic brake. And also, a dentist chair. These are all the example for Pascal's principle. The Pascal's principle is applicable, we know, the lorry, loaded with the lorry, how can you find the weight of the lorry? The weight of the lorry is so in form of tons, we can be able to find out. How can you find? By using Pascal's principle, we are having that lift is called hydraulic lift. This is example for hydraulic lift. So I consider a column as shown in the diagram. In this column, we have to keep your mind, this is larger, this is smaller. So, this diameter is large, this diameter is less. Therefore, I put small f, here I put capital F. That is the thing. If you want to find out the load of your lorry, the lorry may be placed on left hand side. So due to that, what happened? The pressure presses. I already told Pascal's principle, this pressure is equal in all the part of the liquid. We know pressure formula F by A. F by A means on other side. This F force divided by area of this column. And also the lorry, capital F divided by area. So I want to find out this force load of a lorry, capital F is equal to capital A by A into F. What is capital A? Area of the bigger limb. Small a, the area of the right hand side limb. F is the force on smaller side. Okay. The pressure P, that is the pressure P. P is nothing but F L A, pressure is equal to H rho G, like that, force into area, is transmitted to large cylinder. The applied force F gets multiplied by a factor A L A. The applied force F gets multiplied by a factor A L A. Because F is equal to P A. That is a thing you have to understand it. The P F L A is transmitted to large cylinder. This force transmitted to the large cylinder. Therefore, the applied force F gets multiplied by a factor A L A. What is called A? Area of the large cylinder. L, the length of the liquid or height of the liquid. Small a, the area of the lower cylinder. From which the load can be calculated. The force F gets multiplied by a factor A L A. So this is a simple formula for the thing. Then Archimedes principle. The Archimedes principle, everyone aware of that. What is Archimedes principle here? So there is a big well. In your area, you know, large of well are there in the paddy field. So somebody jumped into the well, a big well that supplies water for your paddy fields. Every field has a big well, bore well, like that. Whatever may be the thing. So somebody jumps into the well. If he is knowing a swim or not, that is indifferent. If he knows swimming, easily he has escaped. Suppose, if he doesn't know about swimming, what happened? What are the weight due to this weight and the force just fall into the water? Due to that weight, you go inside it. So after some time, he comes up without giving any force by you. Automatically, you are coming up. So you can see the world. Again, you are going inside. The second side also you are coming up. The third time like that, fourth time you are sink completely. Why you are coming automatically upward? That is a thing you have to know. One point. Another point, you can make a, or you can take water from the well by a packet. But take a packet of water inside the well. So you are rising by a rope. Very easy to move up. If the packet comes out of the water area, definitely you feel how much weight it is. That is a problem. Inside water, it is easy to up. It is also you can enjoy in the swimming pool and other thing. Your friend may be so weight. If it is inside water, you can lift him very easily. When you go away or apart from a water area, it is very difficult to lift him. What is happening? That is Archimedes principle. When a body is wholly or partially immersed in a fluid, It experiences an upward thrust, which is equal to the weight of the fluid displaced. What happens? When you are jump inside the water, due to your weight, equal amount of water can be displaced. For example, take a beaker. In a beaker, full of water will be there. Small stone can be poured into the water. So, due to this stone, some amount of water can be overflowing from a beaker. Kindly collect that water. Find the weight of that water. The weight of the water is equal to how much loss of weight inside the liquid. Both are equal. So, due to that, the upthrust will be there. Because the water has to come out of the beaker means it has to rush from the bottom to up. If it comes up, what happens? It pushes up. Therefore, we feel so light. That is actually loss in weight. But not actual loss in weight. Because of the water, equal volume of water displaces. It comes rushed up. So, therefore, the body also pushed up. That is a meaning. When a body is wholly or partly immersed in a fluid, it experiences an upthrust, which is equal to the weight of the fluid displaced. How much water or any liquid is displaced. Upthrust is also called as buoyant force, B-U-O-Y-A-N-T. Sometimes we are using upthrust or sometimes we are having the force is called buoyant force, buoyancy. Act through the CG, center of gravity of the displaced fluid. The body appears to weightless when immersed in a fluid. Just like just now I told you that it appears to light. Why? Because the force acting upthrust will be there. This apparent loss in weight is nothing but true weight minus upthrust. How can you calculate the apparent loss in weight? I already told you that your weight is 50 kilogram. Suppose you are inside the water means somebody lift you, your weight may be 20 grams. Why the loss? The 30 grams, how it comes? That is a formula. The apparent weight is nothing but true weight minus upthrust. So, our actual weight is 50. The upthrust may be 30. 50 minus 30 will give 20. That is your weight inside a water. How can you find out the apparent weight inside the water? The formula is true weight minus upthrust. A body of volume V and density rho is fully immersed in a liquid of density rho dash. There are two densities, kindly make note of this. The body volume is V, the body density is rho, is fully immersed in a liquid of density rho dash. Then, weight of your body W is equal to rho g into V. How? We know mass divided by volume density. Mass equal to this information I give for your future. Mass divided by volume density. Therefore, mass equal to volume into density. Therefore, mass is equal to volume into density. Weight is nothing but into gravity. That is rho g V. This is the weight of your body. Weight of a liquid, why V? V is the body volume. V is nothing but body volume. G, acceleration due to gravity, rho body density. Weight of a liquid displaced, that is W dash, is equal to rho dash GV, because equal volume of liquid is displaced. So that volume is equal volume of body is displaced. Therefore, G and V are constant. But instead of rho, we have to put rho dash. This rho dash is the density of the liquid. But net downward force or apparent weight, W is equal to, so let us subtract it, rho gv minus rho dash gv, rho gv, true weight minus upthrust, rho gv minus rho dash gv, so gv taken out, rho minus rho dash into gv, or this rho also taken out. Rho gv into 1 minus rho dash by rho. Because how can you take this rho out? So, we have to multiply rho and divide by rho. This multiplied rho taken out. Therefore, 1 minus rho dash by v. This is called apparent weight. W is equal to 1 minus rho dash by rho into W. I already told you that, but this is important formula you have to note down for solving form problems. What is the apparent weight? True weight minus upthrust. That can be also calculated by the formula 1 minus rho dash by rho into W. What is rho dash? Density of the liquid. Rho, density of the body. W, weight of your body. If you are knowing the weight of the body, density of the body, density of the liquid, substitute this, we can be able to find out the apparent weight. So, how much weight is lost inside the liquid? It's a very important formula. No, no, the condition now. So, I have given the formula just now, we know apparent weight is equal to, just now we are saying 1 minus rho naught by rho, just now we are saying 1 minus rho dash by rho, 1 minus rho dash by rho into W. For apparent weight W is equal to 1 minus rho dash by rho into W. If rho dash less than rho, what happen? If rho dash less than rho means 1 minus something positive value. Therefore, apparent weight is greater than 0, positive value. Then the body sink. That means, what does it mean? Very important concept here. If density of liquid is less than the density of the body, the density of the liquid less than density of the body, apparent loss of weight greater than 0, then the body sink. If rho dash equal to rho, the density of the body and the density of the liquid both are same, what happen? Rho dash equal to rho, 1 minus 1, 0, 0 and anything 0. Therefore, apparent loss of weight is greater than 0, first float or equal to 0 or greater than 0, because nearly. Suppose if rho is less than rho, what happen? The upthrust will be greater than the weight of the body. If rho dash less than rho, what happen? So, rho dash more value in the numerator, less value in the denominator. Therefore, 1 minus something is more. Upthrust will greater than the weight of the body. What happened then? Body will move partly out of free surface until upthrust is equal to weight of the body and then float. So that, I already given example, if you are jumped into the well of water, what happened? At first you are coming up. There is a first case. Again go immersed. Again comes up. Second case. And then the body then float. That is a thing you have to understand. So from this only the principle of flotation comes. From this only the principle of flotation comes. What is the principle of flotation? For a body to float in a liquid, the weight of the liquid displaced by the immersed portion of the body must be equal to its own weight. Very important concept. Kindly make note of this. Then only you can understand. Other it is very difficult to understand here. So, kindly make note of this. What is this statement? For a body to float in a liquid, the weight of the liquid displaced by the immersed portion of the body must be equal to its own weight. Then only body can float. So what happened now? If your weight is 50 kilogram or any wooden material has 10 kilogram, the weight of the liquid displaced when the body thrown into the liquid, what happened? Some amount of liquid is displaced. So if it is an immersed portion, remaining portion in the free surface, the immersed portion is like that. This is immersed portion. Must be equal to its own weight. The immersed portion, because it loses some weight, that must be equal to the real weight of the body, then only it floats. If immersed portion more weight, it sinks. That is the thing. Relative density. So somebody having a doubt, a lot of doubt we are having in why the ship floats, but a small pin immersed. That is a density plays a role. Because of that particular density only, the same thing are happening. Relative density. The relative density is not on our syllabus, but most of the problem comes in relative density. The density of the body relative to water is called relative density. The relative density means the density of the body relative to water. We have to compare the density of a particular body to the density of water is called relative density. The relative density or specific density also, or specific gravity. Specific gravity bottle also there once. There is a small bottle with a small cover, by a needle cover will be there. That is called specific gravity bottle. Once we are having so many experiments in this, nowadays we are slowly taken out. Because we are not ready to weigh anything by using physical balance. Have you seen the physical balance? Anywhere in the physics lab. Okay. What is the difference between ordinary balance and physical balance? Can anybody? What is the difference between ordinary balance and the physical balance? You will not say the physical balance are very accurately measured. That answer I am not expecting. What is basic difference between the physical balance and ordinary balance means called a biscuit balance. What is the difference? Have you seen the needle? The ordinary balance or biscuit balance, the needle comes from top to bottom, the sharpness in the bottom side. And go and refer your physical balance, that is a reverse case. The sharp edge is in the upward direction. Then what is the difference? In the ordinary balance or biscuit balance, the needle goes where the weight is more. The direction of the needle goes where more weight of the pan. In the physical balance, that is the reverse is the case. The needle goes where less weight is there. So from this only we can come to the conclusion that we are adding the weight or removing the weight. So very difficult. Why we feel so difficult to measure an object in a physical balance? Even though it is more accurate, if you go to shop, you want to purchase 100 gram mustard or pepper, whatever may be the thing you want to purchase, you want 100 grams, you ask a shopkeeper, come on, give it 100 grams of pepper or 100 grams of any grains. The shopkeeper take the grains in one pan and take a weight, this 100 gram, you can take it. But you ask him, No, I don't want to measure in ordinary balance. Kindly give accurate weight by using physical balance. Is it practically possible to purchase? Why? Because as far as the physical balance is concerned, we have to follow or we have to adapt so many procedures. So both the pans are empty. We have to find the left turning point, right turning point, again left turning point, again right turning point, and we have to find out the turning point A. Keep your mind. Then we have to add the object in the left pan. The weight must be added in the right pan. So we can add weight or subtract weight. Then find the resting point B. After that, add plus or minus 10 milligram. Again find resting point A, resting point C. Then find the formula. The correct weight W is equal to W plus or minus 0.01 B minus A by B minus C. Substitute all this in formula. Finally, we are arrive at the result. Then, the result comes only 90 grams. Again the same thing procedure, very difficult to purchase, isn't it? So we are always in there. So you are purchasing something in our shop, you are simply asking, give dalda 100 gram. Is it correct or wrong? Dalda the word. It is wrong. What is actually you want to purchase? Vanaspati. Vanaspati is correct. But in petty shop, we cannot ask Vanaspati. If you go and ask Vanaspati, it is not available, the shopkeeper says. But if you ask Dalda, yes, you can purchase. Like that, these are the thing usually familiar with the all people. And just like our Dalmia. The Dalmia is a name of a cement. So if you go and give one Dalmia means, the shopkeeper definitely give the cement. Because this is familiar. Why I am telling this, this other thing, even though it is wrong, we are using the same. We are telling the company name and get the thing. Just like your tube light. For purchasing a tube light, it is a correct word, tube light. It is wrong. What is the name of tube light? Come on. Tube light is nothing but fluorescent lamp. Fluorescent lamp is correct. If you go to ordinary shop, give one fluorescent bulb, the shopkeeper immediately refuses. We are not having fluorescent bulb. Next week I will go to Madras, I will purchase for you. Whether tube light is available? Yes. Enormously I am having tube light. How many lights you are? One. So like that, the thing why I am saying that, the practical life is entirely different from subject life. Principle of flotation. For a body float in a liquid, the weight of the fluid. So that the relative density of specific gravity bottle, we have to do this experiment in the physical balance. So that I am telling, so that it consumes large of loss of time. If you are properly loaded, otherwise everything fell down. We have to arrange the physical balance again. Therefore, relative density is equal to density of the body by density of water. We have to keep your mind, the relative density is the density of the body. Density of the body relative to water. Water alone. We have to compare the density of the body to the density of water. That is called relative density. Relative density also another formula, height of water column by height of liquid column. But are you seeing hair separators? U-tube. Have you seen the hair separators? Hair separators are much useful to compare the densities. We can able to find out. H-Rho-G, the formula used, that can be found by using the instrument called hair separators. Hair separators, there is a U-tube, reverse of U-tube. So that can be kept inside the two liquids. So the just we are having the piston in the rubber. So, due to density, the level of water may be different. H1 by H2 is equal to rho 1 by rho 2. That can be calculated. So, relative density, height of water column divided by height of liquid column. That is rho by rho W. The height of water column divided by height of liquid column. That is V rho G by V rho G W, weight of a body divided by weight of water displaced. That is a formula I want to give. Weight of a body divided by weight of a water displaced. That is a thing, the thing we have to understand. That is rho, density of water. This is rho by rho W. Rho W is the suffix. This is a density of the body by density of the water. So we have to compare the density with water. That is now rho into W. So that can be converted into weight of a body divided by weight of water displaced. That is the thing we have to understand it. Volume. Volume into density will give mass. Why this formula comes? Just now we are told, mass per volume density, mass divided volume density. Therefore, mass is equal to volume into density. Volume into density into gravity will give weight of a body. V is the volume, volume into density will give mass, mass into gravity will give weight. Weight of the water displaced, that is V rho Wg. So, kindly make note this W in the suffix. The same formula, volume of your body, volume of liquid. Density of the body, density of water into G. That is called multiply by G, that will give weight of water displaced. So, relative density, we have to keep your mind, density of the body divided by density of water. Height of water column divided by height of liquid column. For example, take a hair separators, that can be other end of the tube like that. Hair separators is like that. Will be there. Here there is a rubber pinch cock will be there in the beaker. In one beaker kerosene may be taken, in one beaker water may be taken. So this is a scale will be there. This is the height of kerosene, this is the height of water. That can be used. So that is called hair separator, weight of your body, that is height of water column. The height of the water column can be measured by using a scale. Height of the liquid or any body, that means any kerosene, that height may be substituted there, that we can find the relative density. Otherwise, this formula, weight of a body by weight of water displaced. Because volume into density will give mass, mass into gravity will give weight. That is called weight of the body. Similarly, weight of the water, volume of the water into rho, other than equal, volume of water and volume of liquid displaced. Weight of water displaced. Hair separators, weight of body by upthrust in water. Therefore, relative density is equal to weight of body by upthrust, loss of weight in water. That is the thing. Both are same. Relative density in terms of upthrust, weight of a body by upthrust, or relative density, weight of the body, loss of weight in water. Everything, the water comes in the denominator. Don't forget it. So, that is called relative density. The relative density is very much useful for us. Why? So we can, using relative density only, we can identify the pureness. We want to go to gold, or to purchase a gold, there is 24 carat or 21 carat or 18 carat. So everything can be, purification can be identified by using relative density only. So there is advantage of relative density. Fraction of volume of floating body inside the liquid. The fraction of volume of a floating body inside the liquid V, body volume, rho density. Floats in a liquid of density rho dash. V dash, volume of the body immersed in the liquid. Since the body is in equilibrium, upthrust equal to weight of the body. What is upthrust? V dash rho dash G equal to V rho G. Or V by V dash is equal to GG getting cancels, rho by rho dash. If the liquid is water, V dash by V is equal to relative density of the body. Otherwise, in terms of volume, we can also calculate the relative density. How can the relative density of the body is nothing but volume of the body immersed in the liquid and also body volume. That is the thing. So, you have to find the volume of the body immersed, volume of the body in air. That is also immersed in a liquid. That is called V. That is also another formula. Flow of ideal fluids. What is ideal? When the word is ideal, what is the meaning of ideal? Ideal, perfect in all sense. You can give an example. Mahatma Gandhi is an ideal man. Why Mahatma Gandhi is an ideal man? You and I are not ideal man. We are not so perfect in all sense. If anything perfect in all sense, we call as ideal. So here, ideal fluids. That means that should be good in all sense is called ideal. Ideal fluid. And incompressible. The ideal fluid is incompressible. We cannot compress it. Non-viscous fluid. So viscous fluid, the viscosity influenced. The non-viscous fluid, very good example for non-viscous fluid, liquid. water. Water has non-viscous. We know glycerol, highly viscous. We know castrol, that is also highly viscous liquids are there. So, the ideal fluid cannot be compressed and also non-viscous. Steady and non-steady float. If the fluid velocity at any point is constant in time, then it is called steady and non-steady float. That is wrong. Flow, F-L-O-W. Kindly make this slide. Steady and non-steady flow, not float. Steady and non-steady flow. If the fluid velocity at any point is constant in time, steady flow. What is the fluid velocity? If you are having a water, comes like that. If it particle crosses the point A, the particle crosses at the point B, the particle crosses at C. If each and every particles are crosses in a particular place, A, B and C has the same velocity. If all the particle crosses A, has velocity V1. So, all the particle velocity must be V1. If it crosses B, the velocity V2 means all the particle which crosses B also V2. If it is like that, then the flow is called steady flow. Okay. If the fluid velocity at any point is not constant, varies with time, non-steady flow. So that we are, so many people are immersed in the water, what happened? If any flood comes, that flow is non-steady flow. In the non-steady flow, the mixture of layers are coming and also we are having a cycle of water. So that all the bodies get inside the water. That is very danger. That is streamline flow in a river flow. In particular river, smoothly it goes, no problem. If there is a mixture of layer comes, the streamline flow become turbulent flow. So, if the fluid velocity at any point is constant, streamline or steady line. If the fluid velocity at any point is not constant, then it is called non-steady. Okay. That is called streamline. It is a curve, the tangent to which at any point gives the direction of the fluid velocity at that point. So, any point we can draw a tangent. If we draw a tangent, that will give the direction. So, in all, you are also studying in your magnetism also. Magnetic field direction can be calculated by drawing a tangent on the magnetic lines of forces. So, just like that, in the flow, if you draw a tangent, the tangent will give the direction. It gives actual path of the fluid. Therefore, steady flow is streamlined flow. Two streamlines can ever cross. And one has no mixture of layer. So, streamline layer, first layer, second layer, automatically it goes. It cannot mix. That is safety for us, one another. The equation for continuity. Why I am coming this portion? The equation of continuity here. If you are having equation of continuity, then only it will be useful for your viscosity. In order to find the viscous force and all Bernoulli theorem, everything, the equation of continuity is very, very important. So, let us consider a tube of different cross section, A1 and A2. This is a larger cross section, this is smaller cross section, P and Q. If a liquid crosses from A to Q, isn't it? The liquid flows from P to Q. The area of cross section at P, A1, Q, A2. The pressure at here, P1. The pressure at here, P2. That is the thing. The velocity of the liquid at A is V1. The velocity of the particle at A2 is V2. Then what is the continuity equation? A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. That is the thing. A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2. Consider a steady irrotational flow of an ideal fluid through a tube of cross-sectional area A1 and A2. At P and Q, V1 and V2 are their respective velocities. Then A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2 or AV is equal to constant. This is called equation of continuity. A1 V1, area into velocity 1 must be equal to area into velocity into 2. So, this is the point, because the velocity of the liquid is inversely proportional to area. Are you accept or not? Then only continuity you can understand. So, you are having a water tube in your home, isn't it? So, one end of the tube may be inserted in a regular pipe, the another end to watering your plant. So, you are handling a tube and you are watering the plant. How you did in your home? Kindly make note of this. This is the tube area. So, you want to make watering for the plant which is far away from you. You cannot go in that direction. In which way you are watering? Simply you are closing. You are closing the tube. If the area of the tube is closed, reduced, what happens? The pressure of water. The water goes faster so that it attains a particular distance. That means the area inversely proportional to velocity. If you close by your finger, what happens? You are reducing the area. Therefore, water goes a longer distance. That is called velocity. That is a thing, area inversely proportional to velocity, or velocity inversely proportional to area. Therefore, AV is equal to constant. Therefore, area into velocity, A1 V1 is equal to A2 V2, that is equal to AV is equal to constant, known as equation of continuity. This AV also called as flow rate or volume flux. This also called as flow rate, also volume flux. What is flow rate and volume flux? The equation of continuity is also called. So, this is the best place I have to stop here. And next class, we have to continue our class with the additional point of the equation of continuity. Bernoulli equation, very very important equation. Also big derivation you are having. That is also important 5-mark question in your final examination. Yes, explain the Bernoulli theorem. We will explain Bernoulli's theorem in the next class. Thank you.